Let's practice calculating a confidence interval around a mean. Now, we can choose whatever level we really want for a confidence interval. However, the most common are 90, 95, and 99. The one that we will use the most is the 95% confidence interval. The 95% confidence interval is the range of values that contains a population parameter 95% of the time. As we look at a confidence interval, we will see the lower limit of the range. We will see the upper limit of the range, and right in the middle is the best estimate, the point estimation for a population mean. We are 95% confident that that population mean lies within that lower and upper limit. Any confidence interval is always the mean plus or minus a margin of error. And that margin of error will increase or decrease based upon whether we've specified 90 versus 95 versus 99%. And as sample size increases, the margin of error will decrease. Let's see if we can apply that. A survey from 70 junk collectors had a sample mean of 9,312 pounds of scrap collected, with a sample standard deviation of 4,007 pounds. Compute a 95% confidence interval around this mean. Turning to Excel, on our Intervals Week 13 spreadsheet, we're going to look at the Means tab. This will allow us to compute a 95% confidence interval around this mean. This is a circumstance where sigma is unknown, and so we will be estimating using a T distribution. Scroll down until you see the box that says do it yourself, sigma unknown, or a T distribution. Let's enter the data that we know. For the sample mean, enter 9312. For the sample standard deviation, 4007. And the sample size is 70. This gives us a 95% confidence interval ranging from 8,365.6 to 10,267.4. Note that you can change the confidence coefficient by changing the 0.95 to 0.90 or 0.99. So now you give it a try. What is the 90% confidence interval around the mean? Is that confidence interval wider or narrower than the 95% confidence interval? What is the 95% confidence interval if your sample size is now 150? And is that confidence interval wider or narrower than a sample size of 70 at 95%? What is the point estimate for the mean? And after you've worked out those problems on your own, here are the correct answers.